Penguin Random House Audio presents Toxic Positivity, Keeping It Real in a World Obsessed with Being Happy. This is the author, Whitney Goodman. For my husband, in good times and bad times, I choose you. Introduction. You deserve more than just good vibes. I would bet there are three potential reasons why you picked up this book. One, you've been impacted by toxic positivity and are sick of it. Two, you don't know what toxic positivity is, but you're intrigued. Three, you have no idea how positivity could possibly be toxic, and you're determined to find out what absolute blasphemy I'm spewing in this book. No matter what your reason is, I'm really glad you're here. Like many aspiring therapists, I got into the field for reasons I didn't fully understand at the time. I knew I liked helping people, and I was obsessed with learning about their stories. But I would later discover, through the help of my therapist, that I actually wanted to get into the profession because I thought if I learned everything about relationships and the human psyche, I could fix everyone I loved and never feel pain again. Fellow therapists and future therapists, I know you get me here. So I entered the field wide-eyed and delusional. I was closed off and hardened. I wanted my clients to be vulnerable without having to be so myself. I thought I would fix people, but no one needed fixing. They just needed to be heard and supported. I thought I would be the all-knowing speaker, but I'm the listener. I thought I would understand myself and the world, but now I have more questions. I thought I'd change everyone around me. Instead, I learned the only person I could change was myself. My motivations for entering the field may have been a little off, but wow, I'm glad I'm here. I love being a therapist, and I've always felt a little rough around the edges among my colleagues. I've never been a meditating, tea-drinking, yoga type of therapist. My voice is too loud, I don't wear cardigans, and I hate all the inspirational quotes on the walls. I tried to make myself softer. I tried to get into the affirmations and all those interventions that tell you to get in touch with your inner child and show it love. I couldn't do it. That's how I felt reading most of the self-help and psychology books out there. They all feel really soft and gentle. I want someone to tell it like it is and to be honest. I had a bit of an identity crisis as a new therapist, and it wasn't until I started posting my thoughts on Instagram as @sitwithwit that I realized there was value in how I wanted to show up. On February 1st, 2019, I was scrolling on Pinterest and saw so many self-help and inspirational quotes being shared thousands of times. The bright colors and whimsical fonts made me irritated. I felt dismissed and concerned for anyone who might see these while in a fragile state. I started a Pinterest board of happiness and inspirational quotes that bothered me and have continued collecting them over the years. That board actually served as the inspiration for the cover of this book. That same day, I shared one of my first charts on Instagram, listing some of those quotes from Pinterest, referring to them as toxic positivity, and providing some alternative statements that I thought offered more validation and hope. This was my first viral post, and my tiny following multiplied in the wake of sharing this chart. I was shocked by how many people agreed with my perspective and how the phrase toxic positivity resonated. It was also the first time I dealt with significant criticism and pushback online from people who disagreed with my perspective. I have continued creating toxic positivity posts on grief, racism, and other important topics over the last several years, and they are some of my most popular and controversial posts to date. I knew I was onto something, but never could have imagined just how much this topic would resonate with others. Toxic positivity is something that I have been aware of for a long time, but didn't have a name for. I saw it in my own home growing up, all over social media, at religious services, in school, and eventually as a therapist with my clients. It was something that I noticed we were all contributing to, but behind closed doors, everyone was telling me they hated it. I was doing it too. It felt like I had to be a part of it or I would be considered negative. It had woven its way into my professional and personal life. Once I noticed it, it was hard to look away. I may have just noticed this phenomenon, but the truth is, it's been around for centuries. Scholars, journalists, and researchers like Sarah Ahmed, Audre Lorde, Barbara Ehrenreich, Gabrielle Onagin, and bell hooks have long been critical of the relentless pursuit of happiness and have eloquently uncovered its destructive nature throughout the world, especially within marginalized communities. Their works were instrumental in helping me understand how pervasive toxic positivity has become. Despite an abundance of research on the ineffectiveness of positivity in various situations, the self-help community continues to push positivity and the pursuit of happiness at every turn. I wanted to find a way to bring this research out of the academic ivory tower and into the modern world. My clients and my personal life are the true inspiration for this book and the reason it exists. This career has afforded me the privilege of sitting in a room with zero distractions and getting to know people on a profound level every single day. It's an experience like no other, and it has taught me so much about life, the world, and human nature. Every single client has changed me in some way. I am eternally grateful for the humanity, struggle, and perseverance I have witnessed and continue to witness within those walls. I've taken different stories from my years as a therapist and combined them with research on positive thinking, emotions, relationships, and motivation to help you understand how positivity can become toxic and what to do instead. All identifying details have been changed to maintain the anonymity of my clients. I hope these stories will help you feel a little bit less alone and show you just how many other people are feeling the way you feel. This is a book I've been writing on Instagram and in my office for years without knowing. It's honest, authentic, and real. It's a book for people who want to know how they can support themselves and others. It's for people who are exhausted from pretending to be happy all the time, at work, at home, with their friends, and on social media. They're tired of good vibes being forced on them at every turn and being told everything happens for a reason. I wrote this book for the people who haven't been able to manifest the perfect life. I wrote it for the humans with too many feelings and too many thoughts. I wrote it for me and I wrote it for you. Happiness and positivity have become both a goal and an obligation. At every turn, we're told that we need to be grateful or more positive. If something goes wrong in your life, it's because you had a bad attitude or you didn't try hard enough. I'm in awe of the ways toxic positivity has woven its way into so many aspects of our lives. We see it in the workplace, in our homes, and in our relationships. It's also a powerful force that helps maintain sexism, racism, homophobia, transphobia, ableism, classism, and other types of prejudice. It really is everywhere. I combed through everything we know about the history of positive thinking and the research on how we can do better and live better. I wanted this book to be easy to read and understand while also being extremely practical. Toxic positivity is divided into 9 chapters, and each chapter touches on a different client's story and relationship with toxic positivity. If you're interested in a comprehensive look at toxic positivity, how it impacts us, and what to do instead, I recommend reading the book cover to cover. For those of you who want to get down to the how-tos, feel free to skip to the chapters that speak to your specific need and experience. Positive thinking has been packaged and sold as the cure to all our problems. From good vibes only bumper stickers to scroll after scroll of prettily designed Instagram affirmations to life is good t-shirts and gurus promising you're only one positive thought away from happiness. We are constantly told that looking on the bright side will help us avoid difficult experiences and feelings. This book might make you feel something other than joy or happiness or good vibes. It might shine a light on habits or phrases that have become part of your daily vernacular. It might make you uncomfortable. I hope it makes you think and reconsider all the ways that you may be suppressing your own emotions and needs in the name of happiness. I hope it makes you think about all the ways you've made yourself smaller or more palatable in pursuit of good vibes. I hope it helps you express your needs and develop relationships based on more than just a good time. If this book allows you to make room in your life for the good, the bad, and the ugly, I've done my job. Just be positive. If it were that easy or effective, we'd all be doing it. allow yourself to experience what it means to be a human, the good and the bad. Chapter 1. What is toxic positivity? Imagine that you just lost your job. You're in full panic mode. Your mind is racing and you have no idea what you're going to do next. You decide to share this with a friend. They glance your way and smile.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.